So the next step is to create this image here, right there. So we're going to take that other C channel and mate it. And I'm ready. So let's take this image. And I'm going to move. I'll start with this object here. So I'm going to rotate this around. Watch this. This is really cool. If you click on it, and then just take the rotation 90 degrees. Just type in 90. There we go. And I'm going to move it in this direction a bit. Yeah, I think that's going to be perfect. All right. So we'll take this image or this face, make connector, and let's choose this region here. Shift, take that spot up top here. And we're going to move that onto, oops, let's go, let's get wonky there. Oh, it's doing that. There we go. Right here. Got weird on me for a second there. Let's go right here. I think I can get there. Let's see. Oh. Got to spin it around. My bad. So got a little crazy on myself there. Spin it around this way. There we go. And it's going to mate to this face right there. So I took the, notice when I mated it, I picked the outside face. And let me just make sure I'm not making any mistake. Yeah, it's going to have to mate to this edge right there. That's right, this edge right here. So I was going to pick the wrong one. It's going to be that edge right there. So let's see if I can make it happen here. That's not activating, so I'm not sure why, what's going on here. So let's refresh this really quick. There we go. Got it now. So let's shift. And right there. Now let's see how that worked. Yeah, perfect. So I just had to mate one particular corner and everything is stationary. See that? And if one is mated, then all of them kind of connect. And you're good to go. And that was it. So let's accept that, and there you have it. So that was easy. All right, moving on. Okay, so the next step here is to insert these items called bearings. So again, we're going to go to insert. Oh, let's get rid of this mate pastor. We don't need this one. So we go insert, and we're going to go again to other documents. And we're looking for, let's just backspace here. Looking for bearings, collars, and inserts. Right there. And then now we're going to click on the assemblies. And we're looking for the high strength shaft bearing with screws. This is it right there. So I click on it. And it's thinking, let's see, I wonder if I had to do the drop down. Maybe. Oh no, just that's it. So there's one. It's high strength, bearing shaft, and screws. If I drop down, it's the same one. Yeah, standard. Doesn't say anything about changing anything. So do it again. I guess I'll just click there. And I'll do it one more time. I think I did need a total of four or three. Well, let's see here. Total of three. Let's double check my image. Yeah, three. So one more. All right, perfect. So what I noticed about the attachments here, these, you notice the rounded area there, that's the bearing, allows the shaft to rotate around in here. So they're connected here, that the round portion is connected here at these notched areas. Okay, see that notch? So there's a square section there, and we'll mate those. And that this round portion is aligned with that. And so we're going to put one here. We're also going to put one over here. Oops, wrong button. Here and here, okay? That's the idea. So I'll do one, and then I'll show the build with the other two. All right, so let's show how this looks. So let's pick our item here, zoom back out. So I can minimize that, it's kind of in the way. Where'd they all go? There they are. And again, sometimes this gets a little crazy, so spin around this way. There we go, it's a good view. So let's take this one. So that one's weird. So I'm gonna place this one. There it is. That's the side. So the bolts are gonna show on the outer edge here, on the outside edge. You'll see what I mean. So let's take this and zoom out just a hair. And this is the hard part sometimes, just get oriented right. Let's go to fasten. And I'm going to click on this here. And I'm going to take that and made it right here. See that notch? Okay, and then rotate the secondary axis and accept. So that's perfect. And I think that's going to be A-okay. Let me double check on what I see here in the actual video. Now, I might be wrong. Let's see. I could be wrong. Let's see what I got here. Let's double check here. Oh, it's on the inside. Let's see. Ah, so I got it the wrong way. Oh, maybe let's see. Oh yeah, so see that? So yeah, I got mine a little off. Let me reconnect. Refresh the browser here. So mine's a little off here. It looks like these need to go the other way around. So let's undo that bait fastener. So that was the wrong way. Okay. So you see that? That was the wrong way. So let's go back to bait connector. And we're going to go here. All right, so this is the side I need to select right here. This side right here. So I selected the wrong side. So we're going to select this portion right here, okay? And so make connector, select this here. We're going to select the center there. So it's this side with the hex connection. Come around, and we're going to connect that right over here. Oh, I picked the wrong spot, so let's undo that. I haven't selected it yet. Right here. Okay, and so now let's rotate. And I think that's going to be right. Let's click select. Okay, and that is not right. Oh, I got to rotate it. That's why. So let's go back over here. I got to rotate that. So let's go over to here. Let's go to this fastener, and I need to rotate it. That's why. So this needs to be rotated, this way, primary axis. There we go. I think that's it. Yeah, there it is. Rotate that. Now that's the right view. Okay, perfect. So that took me just a bit. You want to make sure, oh gosh, you want to make sure that the hole here, let's get out of there, come on. This hole is aligned with the drive axle right here, and it is. If I zoom in right there, see it, it's aligned. And I can go normal. There we go, so it's normal to it. Perfect, excellent. Okay, so we're looking good. So I'm gonna put the rest of these on and then move on, okay? All right, there you have it. Those are connected. The ball fasteners, ball joint fasteners. So now we're moving on. We've got all those connected. Now we're gonna insert the high strength shafts. So 3 1/2, 3 1/4 inch high strength shafts. We want to change those to 2 1/2 inches, and we're going to create just, I believe, just one according to the directions. So just one shaft. So let's make that happen. So let's go to insert, and we're going to go to that high strength shaft. Go back, I guess. We go shafts, configurable, high strength shafts, and we want to go here, I think, right? We want to configure that to how many inches? 3.25. Okay, so that's the one we want this one. So we're dropping this in there, alrighty. Now it says change to 2 1/2 and drop that in there. Okay. Let's drop this in here. Okay, perfect. I think that's right. Let's double check. So, okay, so I got that little part there. I'll just delete it. So there it is. Okay, so I did make a little error there. But there we go. That's the 3 1/2 and the 2 1/2. Yep. Or not the 3 1/2, but 3.25. Yeah, that's it. Now we're going to fasten the 3.25 probably into this motor shaft right in here. Okay, and they're going to give us some directions here. Let's see what it shows. Kind of watch it. So it was fastened right there. Now I'm going to try something different. Watch this. This is how I'm going to fasten it. I'm going to actually take these parts and hide them. Watch what I do here. I'm going to do something totally different when I fasten mine. So let's click over here. And let's hide some of these parts. So I'm gonna hide this part. See that? And I'm gonna mate mine right in here to that plate right there on that backside. It's gonna push right up against that, okay? So let's try this. I think that's gonna be the correct option here. So let's find that. It's here. And I think, well, let's look at the size. I wanna make sure I'm getting the right size. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna measure this. So I'm gonna click on that and I'm gonna hit N to get normal to it. I wanna measure the distance from this edge to this edge. And it says it's 0.34. Let's double check on this. Oh, no, it's a quarter, quarter of an inch. All right, so that's a quarter of an inch right there. See it? Quarter of an inch. All right. So that's a quarter of an inch. Now let's check the motor here. Zoom in here. And I want to get normal to this here. Let's go, well, let's just, guess I can hide this too, so let's hide this. And so let's go right in here. Let's go normal to this. Let's click on that and hit in. Nice. So go to the measuring tool. Let's measure the distance from this corner to this corner. And see it? Let's try it again. I think it's spacebar to undo it. There we go, yeah, spacebar. From this corner. This corner. What's that distance? Not given it, is it? That's the interference detection. I'm clicking the wrong one. That's right. What to measure? It says a quarter. Yeah, so that's the one. That's the one we want. We want that distance from here to here. That's a quarter of an inch. And that's where that that guide axle is going to be connected. It isn't this one, because if you go from here to here, that's smaller than a quarter of an inch. See it? Much, much smaller. So we don't want that. We want this this space. Okay, perfect. So let's make this happen now. So let's grab that axle, which is right over here. Taking the longer, oh, that's not the axle, it's this one right here. Let's take this face and let's go mate. And we're gonna mate that to the motor. Right there, good, shift, center's there. And you notice it's on the wrong side, so we're gonna flip it. And that's perfect. Yep. Look at that. Nice connection there. See that? Perfect. That's what we wanted. And that's exactly what we wanted. Now I hid this, that there, and I can bring it on back. And let's get the other one. Okay, good. Now the other axle is going to be over here. See it? And it looks like that's mated in a different way. Let's see how they show that mate. Yes, I'll made it the way they said to do it that way. It looks like they're mating it all the way to the back edge. There we go. Yeah, back into the cylinder, so I can do that. So let's take this one here. Select this fastener. And let's go back over here. Oh, it's getting wonky. Made it back there. See that, that back edge right there? That's it right there, I think. Double check. Yeah, it looks like it's on that back edge. Yep, let's select it. And accept it. Now, if you want to check for interference, what you do is you choose this tool here. Well, let's get rid of the fastener that we don't want, that one. And then you just go to interference detection and then kind of just highlight certain areas. And it says there is interference here. That's okay. That's part of the, you want that interference because it's a screw. So there's a screw there and these are the threads. So that interference is acceptable. We're looking for interference here though, in the wrong area, and it's perfect. There's no interference. Nice. Excellent. Perfect. But these star drive screws, you want that interference with the thread and the bolt meet. Perfect. Excellent. So far, so good. So we're almost done with this this drivetrain. Looking good. So I'm hoping that you're able to continue the rest of this process on your own. Good luck. Follow the directions. Okay. Piece by piece, step by step, you'll get this done. Like I always say, study hard, learn a lot. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.